Determining the area of a property is a common problem for landscapers. It'd be a no-brainer if everything was rectangular or square, but you can see behind me that we have curves and we even have a flower bed that's shaped like an amoeba. To overcome this problem, I'm going to show you a technique to quickly and accurately calculate the area of irregular shapes. There's a few reasons why this is important. In the irrigation side, we can use it to calculate the precipitation rate of the heads, and it can also be used to figure out how many zones a property needs. In landscaping, we need to know how much material to buy, whether it is sod, hardscapes, or fertilizer. We want to have enough material to finish the job, but we don't have a lot of material left over that will go to waste. Either way, it's going to save you time and it's going to save you money. The best way to calculate the area of an irregular shape is to treat it like a circle. But this is an oddly shaped area, so what I need to do is take at least 16 measurements from the center out in order to get an average radius. To help me do that, I've created a template. This template is broken down into 16 equal parts. I'll set it in the center of the property and I'll use it to guide me around the perimeter. Okay, so what I've done is that I've taken my template and I've placed it in the middle of the property. Now I just eyeballed what middle was. It doesn't have to just be drop dead center. So I have it here, and now because I don't have a friend to help me hold the end of the tape, I brought a screwdriver that I will place right here. And then I'm going to take my 16 measurements around the perimeter and I'm going to measure it to the nearest half foot. So if I get out there and it's 14 feet 4 inches, I'm going to call it 14 and a half feet. Continue recording measurements for the remaining reference points on your template. If you come across an obstruction that prevents you from laying the tape across the guideline, don't worry about that. Just get as close as possible and then move on to the next one. Now that you have your measurements, we're going to take the 16 points that we have and we're going to add them up and we're going to divide by 16 to get the average radius. In our example, the average radius is 25 feet. Now, we're going to put it into the formula to calculate the area of a circle. That formula is pi times the radius squared. So for our example, we're going to take pi, which is 3.14, times 25 times 25, and that's going to be the area of our irregular shape. As you can see, it's fairly simple to calculate the area of an irregular shape, and it will save you time and money. Ewing Irrigation offers more in-depth training through our live educational classes. If you'd like more information, stop by your local branch or visit us online at ewingirrigation.com.